VISTA stands for Vision Science to Applications, and it's a program we have here at York University which focuses on vision. Now, to be clear, we're not just investigating the eye. Most of us are looking at how the brain interprets the images of the eye and uses that. So that has applications in various aspects of healthcare.
We're looking at vision from all sorts of different points of view, from the neurophysiological point of view, from normal vision and perceptual point of view, computer point of view, and from robotics also. So there's many different applications and very many different ways of thinking about what vision is, and York has always been a center for this research.
I like to think it's a two-dimensional space. On the one hand, we're trying to span from biological to computational vision. On the other hand, we're trying to span from pure science of vision to the applications of vision.
We have collaborations with companies like Adobe, with Google, and Qualcomm, who's based here in Canada up in Markham. And these industry partners are the ones who are able to push out this technology. So if you can develop something in the lab, you have connections to partners who can actually realize these things in products that consumers will use.
In our work in entertainment, for instance, we need to work with filmmakers. We need to work with post-production people, and so on, right down to the display manufacturers who put the pixels in front of us in the movie theater in our homes.
We have collaborations around the world with hospitals, industry, and that's where we're able to take our basic research and bring it to applications that will benefit Canadians.
York University is a great home for VISTA because we're already coming into this program as an interdisciplinary university. Now it's been formalized so that it's so much easier to enable this sort of cross-discipline research that we really need. If you really want to get at problems that go from how does the brain work to how do I get my grandmother to not fall in the early stages of dementia? It's really complicated. So you actually need a lot of help. And so it's great we have an environment here that we can do that.